that's what I'm talking about right there. Terms.
Yeah, that looks, that looks way better. We're gonna get shut down because of fucking November rain plan.
November rain.
Yeah,
it's
November
rain. What?
Yeah, it's November rain.
Plan.
Oh, the song.
Because the
song. Yeah, yeah. They're gonna be like, YouTube says you're not allowed to play music. Get that in frame.
Look at this.
Yeah, you're welcome. I rolled a die too to see which one to give you.
Really?
You got pack number two. Yeah, I like to leave everything up to chance, right?
Yeah, that's fine.
So I had two of them from Charles Sue's Fox Break, and like, I don't know which one to give them. I'm gonna laugh if either one of us ever cracks it and pulls a. Oh, it's definitely
Utah. I'll turn it on. What was that one? Because it's on its rechargeable. I want to burn out. Okay.
Well, it's live. We're live.
Oh, hey guys.
I mean, we're not starting. That's okay. Nobody's here.
Box.
Who's here? I see you, one person.
I see you, one person.
What's the sound come through?
Oh, it's on mute, so you don't. We don't hear it.
Otherwise,
I mean, you can, is it going for the NFL? We're still 10 minutes out.
Jesus, these are some baby freaking cases.
I know.
Man.
You know the craziest part is I sent one to France. I actually sent two to France. Are they cool?
They're ridiculous. I think it's like, God.
It's
right?
Well, so
it's like a vault.
It's
yeah.
3/16 instead of an 8. But one of them broke.
What was the price?
One of them broke.
Really?
Oh shit.
Yeah, it's probably cracked.
It cracked.
Yeah, but there's no. I mean, I could slam this on the ground.
Can we turn this off?
Turn it off.
The power. Yeah, one of them broke. It went to France.
Oh, these are cool. Yeah,
I got those off
sure.
France. Yeah, there's one guy on there that has sells them. Like
Mark.
Mark is
yeah.
Mark something. Because
he's
cool.
He's like the agent for a bunch of artists. A bunch of
yeah.
Agents.
This is on like a land. This is one of 24 or 25 from the artist that did it.
Who's the artist?
A guy in England.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we'll go with
it. So you started getting into Magic Art, but not original prints? I mean, these are badass.
I don't have any
original.
Cool.
They're really good.
That'd be way expensive. Like, way, way, way expensive.
Oh, they're prints.
No,
they're
not
prints. Not prints.
Oh, the original?
Oh,
I think Demonic Tutor originals recently sold for like a couple mil?
Really?
Or something stupid. There was a. I don't know if Sarah knew.
These were $250 or $300.
That's not bad.
What's in these? What's in these bags?
Oh, those are the ones you open.
Oh, okay.
On camera, I just put them in there so they're.
Did I get anything good out of them? I don't even remember. I think those were all trash.
Ha!
Well, nothing, right? Well, not good.
What's up, Maddie B? Yeah, we were just looking at the acrylic cases from the Tempest starter break, which are super beefy. Here, let me see. The Tempest.
Yeah.
We'll show it on camera. For anyone who didn't see it, Joe is here with us. Joe's in all the breaks, and he lives in Virginia Beach. I'm up here in Virginia Beach with Matt and Joe. We're doing the break up here today. So yeah, these things are beefy as heck. One of them actually broke on the way to France. Which was kind of crazy. It just like cracked along the back. I talked to the guy and asked him if he wanted. There was one left over from the break. I asked him if he wanted that one. He was like, "No, that's cool." Huh? Oh yeah, he's on. He's here.
Can you hear him though?
No, everyone's just typing. So can't hear anyone. Do you know how the intranet works?
Yeah, I know how it works.
Okay. For an antiquities pack. Yeah, he can do one for an antiquities pack, I'm sure. I'll reach out to him and see. I was thinking about putting in an order for some more starter decks and starter or booster packs. The guy's out in California, and it's a pain in the butt to put these things together. They come all like papered, and there's like screws in them and stuff. I don't know if you can see them. Am I gonna autofocus at all? Yeah, two screws. There it is. But they're cool. I like them. They're like 3/16 inch thick. They're pretty sexy.
Yeah,
there you go.
That thing is ridiculous.
You could probably beat someone to death with it.
Oh,
yeah.
Hello.
Is it open?
Yeah, a little bit.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, it's got that factory cut. Yeah,
is that what it is?
Yeah, they like slit the top and bottom
that's
of the
what Josh calls it. Factory.
Yeah, resealed.
Yeah.
Everything in this video is resealed.
Yeah,
using extra super excellent glue from 1994.
This is pretty cool. I'm excited about this one. I like that it came from a sealed box anyway.
Yeah. Yeah, I was really...
That is ridiculous, these screws.
I know, it was a pain in the butt.
I believe it.
It took me like 2 hours to put the cases together before we even went live.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it was a good chunk of my day. The top-bottom tear lines as straight as possible, not bent. Yeah, that makes sense. I mean, with those old packs, too, we were just looking at some... Well, it was OG Theros, but like the antique packs, the 1994 white packs.
You want to open one of my packs, you don't need.
Do we?
Probably.
Yeah.
This
will be
fun.
All right. Joe says we're opening a pack of Revives, guys. It just got a lot spicier.
You gonna open it?
Open one of them.
He's
yeah.
crazy.
Hey, man. I'm glad one of us is.
I'm not opening mine.
Well, I got multiple, so.
Yeah.
That's cool, man. That'd be awesome.
Yeah. I was gonna, like, I need one sealed for like just.
Same as Fallen Empires. Yeah. There's. You can probably see it on these. Yeah. Let's see if we can get
super thin.
Yeah, see that little cut? That's what you're talking about, right? Yeah, because there's only 8 in Fallen Empires. Alright, well, we're a couple minutes out. See how many people get in here. Let's see if I can... Where's the... Here we go. Share...
That's what we're thinking about. The next box
break
is
going to
be
Antiques. Antiquities? Oh, man.
Oh, was it Antiques? No, it wasn't
Antiques. Oh, Legends.
No, not Legends. Was it Antiques? It might have been Antiques. What was the one that dude had? The
oh, Arabian Nights?
Arabian Nights, that's what I want.
Oh,
to
man.
I'm going to break that box.
Yeah, that'd be nice. Arabian Nights break, though. I would have to think Arabian Nights is going to be... I don't think you'll be able to get the box for under 300 grand.
You think so?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man.
And probably more than that.
More than the beta?
Ha! 2 a.m. Nice.
What?
France in the house.
Oh, nice.
Is that where you are, Galt? Tim? I forget what your real name is. It's Timothy, isn't it?
Well, it says Tim on the back.
He's a... Actually, Tim, Joe, you're... You gave up your pack for Tim to be here.
Oh, sweet.
Brand.
That's
yeah.
awesome.
So.
I got one of them.
Yeah, so Joe's here, Tim, so you can personally thank him for giving up a break. And we also have to thank Pierre Luigi, who is in... Pierre's in Italy. But he gave up a pack for Eric Obayashi, who's been in pretty much every break that we've done so far.
Turn it down.
Which one? That's the Somos ones?
Yeah.
I almost bought the Somos, but then I ended up buying the Wilkins and Bowers. I found an open box, so I couldn't say no. It was literally the sound bar was cheaper than the Somos sound bar as
high.
An open box.
Yeah.
But it's like, it's just super crisp.
I'm pretty happy with the Somos.
No, I just, like,
The only problem is I just didn't think that through all the way, because the extra little things, I think, are like $800 for the little things like these things. Because I got the soundbar for cheaper than the Sonos soundbar. And then I got the bass, like a really good price on the bass.
And they hooked you in on the soundbar and the bass.
Wow. Now I'm going to end up having to pay so much more for the other stuff.
Yeah, it's,
wow. Wait. Oh, look at that beauty.
Sexy. Mm-hmm. Sexy. All right, everyone, I'm hard, officially.
Officially, like rock hard.
Let's get it going. Looks like we got a couple people here. We'll wait 5 minutes for a couple more people to show up. I just sent the link in the chat. Oh my god.
Boo!
So this is in the prize pool. One lucky person will win this 8.5 Lotus.
The box he just had.
What'd he do with the
right here.
I'm gonna surprise open this.
Matt has his personal box over Vise that he just broke out. He wanted the acrylic box. So we're just going to open that on camera. He's also giving away his 8.5 Unlimited Lotus to one lucky winner.
I don't think that's a thing.
That's not actually happening, guys, just so you know.
That'd be awesome if it was.
We'll do something like that when we, like, I don't know, when we get crazy.
Yeah, when we decide to break an Arabian Nights box.
Yeah, when we get stupid successful one day, we will do that. Brian, what's up, man?
Imagine giving away a Lotus.
I would love to.
Yeah.
That would make my day.
Yeah, like me too.
I love giving shit away. But I just can't. I can't justify it currently.
No.
Oh, it looks pretty.
It looks real pretty.
I like it. Yeah.
Your box is much cleaner than this one.
I was about to say, yeah, that box is really pretty. It looks better than that thing.
When did you buy that one?
3 years ago.
For what? $500?
$4,000.
Matt's the one that found this box. So
really?
Say that.
Oh.
He found a shop in South Dakota that was guy closed years and years ago, and this was down in his basement. Two boxes of this. And
oh, did he bought the other one?
Yeah.
And then sold it recently?
Yeah, he sold a couple months ago.
That's awesome. It's amazing how much things are worth.
Yeah, I mean, even in the soft market, I've been picking bulk for just because I've got, like, I don't know, a million Magic cards in my office, and a bunch of it hasn't been gone through since I moved out of Denver last year.
Oh, wow.
And so I've been repicking through it now that the prices spiked and everything, and now everything's softened. But I mean, I was uploading some revised cards, and I'm like, Zombie Master's up to like $5-6.
Oh, like a common?
Well, Zombie Master, I think, is a rare, but. Still just like these offbeat rares, you know. Not that Zombie Master is not a good playable card, but just I never would have thought. What's up, Mark? Welcome to the party. Mark snapped up the last pack that was up for grabs.
How much
are
the spots?
500 apiece. All right. Well, we got 6 people here out of the probably 15 or so that are in the break. A couple people, we got someone in Spain. I think Philippe's in Spain, Pierluigi's in Italy. I don't think we have any of the Australian guys in this break. And Tim's in France. So we're spread out all over the world tonight, so I imagine some people won't be tuning in. Also, some of our folks are in California, so it might be a little early. They're probably eating dinner with the family and whatnot. But this, of course, will be saved forever on YouTube. So anyone who wants to check in later certainly can. Anyone who's in the break, there's in the group chat. I posted a link. Although I think I added everyone in. Yeah, I think everyone's in there. So, oh, we got a fancy knife.
Nice.
That's good, because I didn't bring my fancy knife. I just have
my
shitty knife.
I brought my Infidel.
Yeah.
All right.
I found one of those in freaking a gun show. Like, it was super cheap. I was like, what? This isn't real.
Those are huge. They're huge, aren't
they? Yeah, it's like this big. Yeah, it's a big knife. It's just fun to play with. I use it all the time. All
right, before we break her open, why don't we'll figure out where we're going to start. So we'll do the the roll.
How many is that? Oh, 70?
Do it. Yep. Let's zoom in so everyone can see. We got a 7.
D.
7D. So we will. Let's go over here to random. We'll randomize 7 times, and then you guys know the drill by now. We're going to, wherever it starts, that's going to be pack 1 from the list. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's really weird.
Yeah,
it was all single digit numbers.
Yeah, that was really
weird. It says min 1, max 36, but we're starting to pack 7, guys.
That was really weird.
That was very strange. I've never seen that before. So here's the list. We'll start at pack 7. So Francesco Biondi, your 2 packs will be first. All right. 7 is the number for the night, apparently. Wait. Oh. Let's go down. Ooh. 30. Yeah. Oops. All right, there it is. Joe, you're always at the end, bud.
It seems like it, doesn't it?
You're in the middle too.
I am in the middle. I got a couple more, right?
Do you want to break a pack?
Yeah, I think I do.
Do you want to break pack number 31 or 32?
Which one do you want to go odd or even?
Do you want to roll for it?
Yeah, I do.
All right.
I'll use this gold dice right
Hold
here.
Hold on. Let's see. All right. Joe's going to roll for which pack to break.
So odd or even. So odd. So
all right. 35. So we'll go for
31.
We'll go back over here. All right. Joe's going to crack a pack because he's crazy.
I live on the edge.
All right. So here's the list, guys.
Huh?
Yeah. There's where everybody's at. Boom, boom, boom. We'll get to cracking.
I kind of like this price that's on it right there. We should try to see if we can get more of that price.
You'd be hard-pressed to find a booster
box.
$66.
Yeah, that's amazing. That's insane.
It's pretty awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Name another asset you could have invested in that would have appreciated.
Like this?
Like
what's
that.
Okay, now I got to do the math.
I mean, besides like Amazon.
Last gets the Lotus.
Like a stock or something like that, yeah.
What's he doing?
Brian says last person on the list gets the Lotus.
Is he the last person?
I'm assuming so. Let's see. I think so. Yep, he's the last. Of course. Let's see. If you did
Brian also get like 6 packs?
Yes.
Yeah.
Brian got 6 packs.
Yeah.
66.16, is it? 66.15. What would that math be? Times, oh no, wait, if you do 15.
Are you trying to do the percentage of inflation?
Uh-huh, the percentage gain divided by.
That's 6.
That's 226 times. So
yeah.
This has appreciated 226 times over its initial value of $66.15. I wish there was a date on that. Oh, there is, 4/25/95. Let's get a close up of that.
95.
I'm saving this wrapper. $425.95. This was $66. So now we all know what it was priced at now. All right.
You better ready to do it.
I'm ready. As Open Booster says, through the looking glass.
Yeah. Open Booster.
Yeah.
Oh. That's brutal, man.
Oh, that's so, I mean, it's, and Brian, you are getting this box. Brian bought the most amount of packs, so he requested the box, and I said, you know what, dude?
It's fair.
It's
100%
fair. Fair is fair. And I hope for Will Unseals, there is a ticket in the bottom of this. If anybody doesn't know, if you break open old boxes and there's a ticket in the bottom, Will Unseals. He collects these tickets. Oh, we got a little bust in the side over there. Looks nice.
He collects the tickets,
and I think he's doing like some sort of raffle. Whew. All right, we'll save this for a super reseal job. We'll reseal a box of Arabian Nights with that.
Wait a minute. Oh, no. The price difference.
Oh, right. All right, guys.
Oh, those are
beautiful. Oh, we got shifted packs. They're everywhere. All right, we're just gonna go like this. I think that's probably...
What happened?
What happened.
Uh-oh, now it's upside down.
No, now it's upside down.
I don't know what to do with that life.
If anybody thinks that should be done differently, speak now or forever hold your peace.
Just hold the peace.
Just...
Wait, right. I feel like this thing should be like flipped around, though, just for fun.
Okay, flip it around.
Look,
all right, there it is.
There you go.
No manipulation.
Extra manipulation. They feel like there's 12 in each.
Do they?
Yeah, kind of.
But there's 15 in each.
No, there's not 45 packs in here.
Oh, yeah.
If so, we have a lot of extra packs.
I was thinking 15.
I think Alliance is the only one with 45. And then 60 is Fallen Empires. And
yeah, almost ridiculous.
And is Antiquity? No, the Dark. The Dark is 60, too.
Dark has 60?
Dark has 60.
Because like, only 8 cards back, so I guess that makes
yeah.
sense.
Same with Fallen Empires. All right, so I guess what I'll do is I'll put them in the pack, seal it. Do you want to, like, put a sticker on it? Or do you want to do nothing?
No, I'll have some responsibility. That's fine.
All right. All right, guys.
But your signature is much cooler than mine, so you're going to sign them all.
Oh, I definitely got to sign them.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
So I'll just, we'll go for pack number one. Pack number one is going to be... See, this is the hardest part. I got to have all three screens open. Well, I guess I don't need that screen open, really.
Well, there you go.
Pack number one is Francesco Biondi. Oh, I think he's in Italy, too. Just make sure I put these
sounds
in the right way.
Good assumption.
Yeah. Yeah.
I was thinking Germany, but, you know...
I was thinking like Sweden or something.
I don't think we've ever sold packs to anyone in Sweden. Well, we've sold boxes. The revised starter deck box went to someone in Norway? Sweden?
The revised
Belgium? Belgium.
No, Belgium was the starter deck.
That was
the
Norway.
Beta starter deck.
I think it was Norway.
Norway? No, Switzerland. Switzerland is where the revised starter deck box went. All right, that looks really pretty. That looks really pretty.
Yeah,
and we're drinking. Currently, we're drinking Johnny Walker Blue, guys. Toast, cheers to y'all. Joe brought a nice bottle of Johnny Walker Blue. And we'll do this seal. And where's my marker? There it is. All right, this is gonna go super slow because I'm already a little tipsy. Today is the 10th, right? 10th?
Yeah.
Number one.
Oh. Yeah.
You're slacking. You're over here slacking.
I don't know that I should have that responsibility. I mean, it seems like it all just flows when you do it.
Yeah, all right. You guys can just chill. I'll just pull the work. It's fine.
Dude, you're the talent.
Sante!
We're nothing.
You have to roll the dice.
Oh yeah, that's right. We're doing prize packs. What am I thinking?
Yeah.
All right, so as far as here, you roll the dice, Joe.
Right.
As far as prize packs go, we're gonna do. We've got 6 different sets of boosters. We've got lottery packs over here. It's Hour of Devastation and Amonkhet. We've got Ixalan and Rivals of Ixalan. We've got 1 Battle Bond and 2 Eldritch Moon. And then we've got Ravnica Allegiance and some War of the Spark and some... This is the lamest pile, probably. Throne and Theros and Fallen Empires. And just like always, we'll have it... Let me see if I can get this light a little... It's a little dark.
Do you
know if it's too dark, guys.
Well, you know what? You can tip it up or...
Or do you want to bring that light over a little bit?
This
is
one?
That one plugged in?
Well, where are you dark at? Where are you?
Oh, we're good. We're actually good.
I was saying, you're pretty
yeah,
light
no, we're good now. We're good. That looks good. Yeah, go ahead. So this will be for Francesco. He's 2. You're getting a pack of Throne of Eldraine.
Nice.
Crack it open. All
right, I'm gonna crack it open.
Yeah, do the thing. Do the thing, and then I will pack up his second pack.
Nice.
Yeah, Francesco got 2 packs.
Kind of like rip the pack open or something like that too bad. And of course, there it goes.
Make sure it's not dog eared, make sure they nice go in nice and pretty for $500 a pack. I'll make sure these look well. I'll try to make sure these look good for you.
As it goes for the, let's see here. So we got Crystal Slipper, Silver Flame Squire, Mantle of Tides.
Are you gonna slow roll the comments for us? Oh jeez. Joe slow rolling.
I don't know. Let's get to the good stuff, I guess, right? Knight of the Keep, Fireborn Dude.
Oh, I always love the art for Tournament Grounds. I always thought it should be worth something, but it's not,
right.
Unfortunately.
Sire.
Oh, Stunpool Serpent. That's
rare.
Not bad. That's not too bad. That's good, like $3 rare.
Oh, and we got a
foil. Oh, and the foil rare. All right.
Black Lance.
And we continue the trend of insane single pack openings on this channel.
On an adventure. That's fun.
Rock and roll. All right, Francesco. It's all you, bud. So what I do is I put the prize packs underneath the actual packs, and then I know when I'm packed, it's going to be a pain to transport all this. And well, yes. I can put... You've got bubble mailers, right? I can put everyone's in a bubble mailer and just write their names
out.
Yeah. All right, that works. All right, Francesco is dunzo. Who do we got next? Paul Dolan's got four packs. Go ahead and roll it up for Paul.
Three.
Number three. All right, Paul, you're getting a pack of Ravnica Allegiance.
All right, so we got going on here.
And I will start packing your four packs. This works well. This will make it go a lot faster.
Right. Super fun.
Matt's playing Candy Crush on his cell phone.
Oh my god. I haven't played that in years. Long time since I played that.
See some fun stuff.
Sexy.
I was like, ooh, crocodile.
Ooh, catacomb croc.
Yeah.
Do you guys have crocs up here?
Not up here. Wayfinder.
I don't think there is a, so.
There is
I don't
a,
know.
There is a foil in here.
Oh, there's. Two packs, two foils. Oh! Right. Everyone knows the split ones are the best.
And then we got a...
A shark dough crab.
Shark dough. Jesus. That is crazy looking.
I have never seen that.
It's like a hammerhead shark, like with a...
Oh, wow.
With a crab with crab legs. Yeah, I don't know if I've ever seen it either. I'm pretty...
That's
I'm sure
bit,
I have.
That's a bit of a womp-womp pack. No, no, what's the good ones in Ravnica Allegiance besides the Shocklands?
I don't know what else besides Shocklands is good in.
There's the Gitrog Monk? Not Gitrog Monster. What am I thinking?
Thing that looks like a big frog. Is what you
Oh, it's the Hydra dude.
It's been a while since I've messed with Ravnica.
As you can tell, as we break this box of revised, we don't do new cards. We just do the old ones.
I have fun with it. I've played in some tournaments, but not recently.
Yeah, I usually do pre-releases when it, like, I think...
The pre-releases are a blast, though.
Yeah, pre-releases are fun. Paul, that's your second pack. Pack number four. Officially 1/9 of the way through this booster box.
What did you?
I shake it to get it dry.
Oh,
I don't want the
I
don't want
ink.
The ink to.
He doesn't want to mess up his sig.
Is that what?
One day my signature is going to be worth $0 because I've signed so many things.
And then when you die, I'll be like Stan Lee. Can't get any more. Even though he signed everything.
By the way, I don't know about you. This is the first time I've ever seen a revised.
Yeah,
but I've never been beside a revised box that's been opened.
No,
me
neither. Yeah, that's nice. Yeah.
I've never opened a revised box.
I'm pretty sure I've opened packs, like, when I was younger.
I don't think we even ever opened revised when I was younger.
I feel like
I remember getting some gifted to me.
Yeah.
Like Lucy cards, but not...
I had a buddy of mine that was really into it, and he, like, just had thousands of cards, and I remember going and buying some, whatever, because he used to, like, the Star Trek cards back in the day.
Oh.
Then he switched over to Magic in, like, 96, I think.
I'll say this. Everyone talks about, you know, if they only would have bought Magic versus baseball.
Oh, man.
But, you know, you think of $66 for this box. When I was
10,
12, 10,
oh, well, no,
$66.
You were like 26 in 1995.
It was a huge amount of money, dude.
Yeah.
I don't know that I would have bought
A box.
Like a box of Magic. I would have bought packs.
The first time I bought a box.
I would have bought a lot of PlayStation games with it.
Yeah. Or a Nintendo game.
Yeah, yeah. Nintendo game.
Very true.
But even then, I mean, I had to save up for a long time to get a Nintendo game back in the day.
Yeah,
so
long time.
The fact that you would say, oh, I would have bought, you know, the chance you'd have would have bought revised boxes when you were a little kid and you never opened them.
I mean,
yeah,
I was 7.
Yeah.
And like, no way I would have had the thought process to do that.
Yeah. You would have ripped it open, had time with it.
Yeah. And loved every minute of it.
I guess that's why you have to appreciate there's even so many, I mean, so that even as many have survived.
That's true. I mean, we have seen a lot come to market in the last year, too. Just the amount
people are realizing, hey, I have some of those somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, let me check this. That's 4.
That's 4, right?
Okay.
All right. So who do we got next? Paul, those were your 4 packs. Pierluigi, who also gave up a pack. He gave up pack number 34 for Eric Obayashi. So we'll do 2 packs for Pierre. You want to roll the die for Pierre and see which pile he's getting? Number 3, War of the Spark. All right.
That's at least a good one.
It is a good one.
Like, I like this a lot, actually. This is probably one of my more favorite sets to, like, open
you
up.
You want to, you can, if you want to start putting card backings in there,
I can do that.
Then they can be teed up for me.
Can
you handle that?
I
think you do the low stress job.
I mean, I think it's low stress. All right, it's pretty.
This is pretty good.
Yeah. You sure it's a low stress?
You're going to have to hand them to me when we get to
them. Oh,
still. Alright, let's see. Everybody's seen most of these cards, probably. So maybe we can get a cool freaking Planeswalker in this one.
Ah, I freaking dog-eared it.
Dog-eared it, bro.
It's getting undone. We're gonna have to go in there and do some surgery.
Unfortunately, an uncommon Planeswalker.
Uncommon Planeswalker and the Dread Horde Invasion.
Yep, and
then a lot of these packs are dog-eared, guys, so I'm gonna try to make them work.
You
want to
try these?
Huh?
They're bigger. They're a lot bigger.
No, I like these because they're perfect.
Oh. But they're...
Oh, those are graded card sleeves.
Yeah.
See, those won't work anyway.
Yeah, they do work.
No, you want these ones.
They're perfect. No, I mean, as far as size, they're bigger.
Perfect. I know.
Yeah.
No, they need to be perfect.
Let's see.
I know. I'm an asshole.
Right?
I'm a bit of a perfectionist.
Just ask the guy we just bought the revised set.
Right. We just bought a near mint revised set, and I wasn't there to inspect when we bought it, but Matt was. And I gave the guy, we
what
talked for
Legends
like an
pack?
Hour. Huh?
What was the Legends pack? I don't know. Somebody's asking me how. I sent a buddy some pictures of them.
Oh, I think 1,000? Or 900? I think I gave you 900. Something like that. I don't remember, dude. I think I started at 1,200, too.
No, yeah, I bought a bunch of stuff from him, so.
What was this? Pack number... Pierluigi, pack number 7.
He just bought a Pokemon pack for me for, like, $300. This guy.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What Pokemon pack is this?
I don't remember. I won it at, like, an auction for, like, $120. So I was like, oh, that's not bad. It's a $350 pack.
That's not bad at all. Alright. See those dog ears? I'm going to try and get them out. See,
is there a way to?
Well, I'm just going to, like, bend it. I just don't want it to be dog-eared in the pack first.
Search now.
Oh,
searched. Guys, we're searching these packs as we do them. As you can see on camera, we are certainly searching them.
We are.
Everybody got an underground C so far, so. Here, Luigi, this is your pack number 2. You will also have a 3rd pack later on down the line. Yeah, you can.
Oh.
Fuck shit ass.
I couldn't remember. Oh, yeah, that's right. You can set it whether or not this is for kids. Or
this is certainly not for kids.
Oh, can you actually set it like that?
It's only a...
Yeah, you have to.
It's only a kid's card game that... We're opening. It's not for
kids. I think this era is an adult's card game.
This era, I think, a bunch of guys in there.
All right, so
cards.
Next is Kyle Watts. Kyle, you've got 1 pack. Better make it good. You want to roll the die?
Yeah, that's what we got. 1.
Number 1, Fallen Empire. Sweet. Cracking 94 and packing 94. That's what I like.
Well, packing 95.
Patty 95. Well, no.
Is it 94? Well, yeah, I guess that's one of the probably after tax was box 95.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
This one, I think, revised in 94.
Might be right.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, just demolishing it. Just Kyle, I hope you didn't want that wrapper.
I'll keep the front of it nice for you. But it's not being nice to me right now.
Yeah, the Fallen Empires ones kind of are a pain in the butt. Okay, that looks good.
Oh my god.
So Matt says we're getting these, like, when it zooms in on your hand, that. Can you do anything with that?
What?
Oh, interesting.
Do we know how these things,
that
rare
makes
those
sense.
Ones?
Let me see if I can.
Or if there's a rare.
Rare is either in the back or it's the fourth slot. Let me see if I can turn these things off, guys.
I don't know if you want to mess with it.
I'm going to mess with it. Let's see if I can.
Like, crash the whole stream.
Camera settings.
Well, there's some lag, isn't there?
Live view. Oh, yeah, there's definitely lag. Mirror, live view display. Nope, that's not what I want.
What's the big card in Fallen Empires?
Rainbow Veil?
Rainbow Veil.
Are we still? Oh, wait, what's going on?
I don't know, I'm frozen, though, like, completely.
Oh, you're good. You're now sure. You're not, yeah.
Oh, it's just going really, really slow?
Yeah.
On the Alive's part?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right, fair enough.
No, it's just, yeah, there's like a 10-second delay. 5-10-second delay. Something like that.
Spawning bed. That's kind of new. At least the center is freaking on point on this.
Oh! One. Hand of Justice! That's
Hand
a good
of
hit.
Justice.
It's like a $5 card. That's about as good as it gets.
All right.
I mean, near mid Hand of Justice.
Thalia.
Nice hit, Kyle.
Orcish Veteran.
Yeah, Matt, I don't know about getting those things off. I wish somebody had told me. I think that's like that all the time. But.
That's kind of cool looking. Necrite.
Oh, yeah, the Necrite art.
Yeah.
Rush, dude, of course it's cool. It's Mr. Rush.
Naked dude. In a hammock.
We got number nine. Naked dude in a hammock.
Jesus. That thing got destroyed.
It looks alright. Doesn't look too bad. Yeah, Matt, you're right about the autofocus thing. I don't know how to get rid of that on the fly. It usually doesn't have that, though. I'm wondering
what's
going on.
Oh, that weird thing?
Yeah, it's...
Is there something to click on it on the camera?
Let's see. Okay, guys. Let's see if we can... Hold on. Don't move the camera.
I think I did what I said a minute ago.
Yeah, it's all right. No, let's not fuck with it.
Okay.
Let's just... Go with it.
Go with it.
It usually doesn't do that. I'm not sure why...
That was Paul D.
That was Kyle Watts.
Kyle Watts.
Next up, we got John Caserta with pack number 10.
Oh, Paul's already gotten his.
Yeah, Paul's already got his. Do you want to give it a roll?
Roll the dice. Two.
Two.
Theros.
Oh, I know why.
Why?
Oh, wait, is it on autofocus? Huh, I'm not sure why it's doing that. It doesn't usually. All right, number two.
Alrighty.
We're on pack number 10, and it looks like, it feels like we are on the right track to get 12 in each stack. So that's good.
Sure hope so. How often do they short them?
Not shorting, but just to make sure that it's not like super shifted,
yeah.
You know?
Let's see what we got going on here. Is it focusing in there? I can't even tell.
I can't even tell either. Oh, here. There you go.
It's focused up, I think, right?
Yeah. I don't know why it's doing that.
It's a unicorn. Don't leave a comment on this thing.
Huh.
Sage of Mysteries. And for the rare.
Oh, Nick's
Ooh,
Lotus Rare.
That's a really nice one.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
Good hit, dude.
And a foil hidden codes.
So for anyone who's doing box breaks of Theros and runs a TCG player store, if you're doing a lot of Theros breaks, the lands actually sell for over $1 a piece at market price. If you've got like a TCG, yeah. If you've got a direct store, they'll sell for $1 a piece. So when you break a box, you get like $36, you know, minus fees and everything, for breaking the box just with the lands alone. So it's actually a good box to break for singles.
Where is this at? Because I definitely have a billion of those lands, I'm sure.
Just selling on TCG Player.
Oh, TCG, okay.
Yeah. All right, who do we got next? Next, we've got Graham Alexander. Graham's got one pack.
All right, let's go ahead and
roll it up.
Nice. Five.
Number five. Oh, Ixalan.
Rivals of Ixalan. I have definitely opened my fair share of these boost boxes.
Yeah?
I never like opening packs.
You don't say.
Yeah, right?
I think by this point, everybody knows you like opening
packs. All right. Oh, yeah. Oh, what do I say? All right.
You got, like, seven weather. No, more than that.
I think I'm, like,
eight weather lights. And you open, two.
Brahmin.
Dark Charger.
So this is pack number 11.
That is an interesting green knife. It's, like, a mixture between Zelda and something weird.
Oh yeah, this is very strange. I don't know, the art in Ixalan I just can't get into.
Yeah, they're weird.
It's definitely
really
different.
And I think this next one right here. Yep, next one's right.
Ixalan's still really not over.
Okay. Oh, Wayward Swordtooth. That's like
yeah.
a $10 hit.
Okay,
bucks
nice.
A box.
A dinosaur.
No, it's more than that.
Is it?
Yeah, Rivals of Ixalan's like
no,
100.
Ixalan.
Oh, Ixalan? They're like $1.20, I think. $1.10. It's valued up too. Rivals of Ixalan, though, is like, I think, $150.
Bucks. $180 on eBay.
Yeah. Scalper. You freaking scalper.
What eBay's there for.
All right. So that was Graham. Now we got two packs for Mark Goldwell. And then Mark's going to get a third pack later on.
Five again.
Number five. All right. Rivals of Ix again. You're probably not going to get a Wayward Swordtooth.
Wayward Swordtooth.
Let's look that up.
I think that's a $10 card.
$10 card is the call out. It's called Wayward
Swordtooth. Like maybe eight to $10, something like that.
Hey, look at that. We're rising
now.
What am I doing?
It's $10.
It is.
Called it.
But that Nyx Lotus, was that like a few dollars?
Nyx Lotus is like $3 to $5, I think.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It's a great playable.
Absolutely. I gotta get into Commander. I've never really gotten into Commander. Whoa. They like green, apparently. Like that sword was green, this is green.
Yep. It's very colorful.
Colorful.
Set.
Alright, so we got for a rare Storm the Vault.
Oh, that's decent. That's $5 rare. Man, no bulk rares in this poll so far. He got a Hand of Justice from the Fallen Empires back.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean,
it's like the second best card in the set. Only thing beats it is a Rainbow Veil.
Alright,
that's the end of the first row, guys.
Excellent.
And we got one more for Mark Goldwell, so... Oh, yeah. Let me put a Fallen Empires pack in there. Your second pack. If you got three packs...
What's up? Is it still on camera?
Yeah, everything should be...
I mean, I can set this over here.
Yeah,
oh, it doesn't happen. Once they're sealed, they're fine.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Yeah,
just make sure they're all in order.
Yes.
Actually, if you want to, well, no, we should have started at the beginning. I was going to say put them in bubble mail and write people's names on them, but.
Yeah, you would definitely want to do
that. You're like,
asking for a lot right now.
How many of these have you had?
Yeah.
On drink number three. The Fallen Empire is now inked, damaged. Oh, that's true. Look at that. It's inked.
Oh,
I inked
no.
it.
Oh, my gosh.
Dude, what is wrong with you?
Revised would be... Nope, you're getting Fallen Empires. I decided mid-break, $500 for a Fallen Empires pack. What is this? Number 13? I just gotta make sure. Yep, number 13. Alright, Mark, that is your pack number 2 of 3. All right, who do we got next? We have Brian Saja.
Brian,
I have no idea how to say your last name. I'm just going to say Saja.
Or what is the
P is silent.
P?
Yeah, Brian P.
P salad?
You gotta say the full name.
Six hours
of dev. All right, let's pull a freaking lottery card. What is it? Invention. Invocation.
Is this the one that you pull a lottery card?
Invocation. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that'd be...
Yeah, Hour of Devastation and Ammo Kit both have invocations in them. So there's, like, what's the best one you can pull? A Force of Will? I think there's a Force of Will invocation. There is. Yeah.
Nice.
So
there's a bunch of...
Let's hit one of those, or any invocation would be great.
I got a time spiral? No. That was the weird one I got from the one pack.
It's a one card per case hit, so...
Is it one per case? I thought it was
one
per four boxes.
One to two, I think.
One to two a case.
Yeah,
something like
yeah.
What is the card?
Well, it's just any of the invocations.
You'll notice.
It's illegible. You can't read it.
You'll be like, whoa.
Yeah.
Right. Oh.
Didn't
get it.
Adorn Pouncer. Okay. That's not bad. It's a decent hit. I mean, it's not worth anything, but it's playable.
Looking, yeah.
Playable cat. Building a Rin and Siri deck, Brian, I hope. What's that, number 14, I think?
It would be, yeah.
Number 14. 14's a little fucked up on there, but you'll see it. All right, now we got four more? Brian, this run is five, and then you got one more down at the bottom, I think.
When was that, 14? Oh, so Kyle Watson's next.
One, two, three, four, five. Oh, no, you got one in the beginning. That's right. Okay.
Yeah, that
so
one
you got
Mark?
Five right now. Huh?
Is that one from Mark? Is that what that was?
No, this is Brian.
Oh, Brian?
Yeah. Mark has three. We did two for him. He's got one at the bottom of the run.
Oh, okay.
Brian's got one back at the top, like, kind of right under you.
Oh, okay.
Wow. This pack is... not wanting to play.
These things.
They're annoying.
Yeah.
I got a bunch of team bags. I think I got the same things as these things. Where'd you get these at?
The cards? I'll have to send you a link. Michael Jewell sent me the particular links for these team bags and these.
I have a bunch of regular team bags, which is not a big deal, but...
Yeah, these ones are, like, the perfect size.
I see that.
That's why I like them.
I just like the little back things. With all the packs I got, I want to put them in these things.
Yeah, and it's, like, the perfect card weight, too. Cardstock weight. It's, like, just firm enough. No giggity, guys? No giggity? Just firm enough?
Just firm enough.
Come on. Come on.
Gonna go somewhere with that.
Well, we're almost to the halfway point.
Mesmerized by Darius's signature.
Right? Have you seen, Steve Aoki was breaking a bunch of Pokemon cards and like giving away his shoes and everything like that, and his signature was like all ridiculous.
I haven't seen that guy.
Steve Aoki, he's a
trans musician.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He was like trans.
And now he's like a YouTube Pokemon guy?
Yeah, because I think he must be bored or something like that. But he must be bored. His stuff goes for like between $2,000 and $4,000 like per pack kind of thing, but he'll like you'll get a ridiculous pack. So then like I think last time I did was like a Rocket First Edition or something, and then like you'll get a spin on the wheel, so you'll get a pair of shoes that he'll sign and everything like that.
Oh jeez.
Yeah, it's kinda ridiculous.
Hey, it must be. Board or
we're making hand over fist money on it. He's like, this is better than DJing.
Yeah.
Right? Well, it's like, what else? I won tickets to see him right before the pandemic hit.
And then the pandemic hit.
I was really sad about that, actually.
Did he, like, reschedule the show?
I don't remember. How many packs did he have? Four or five?
Five.
Five.
This is his last one. Well, in this run.
In this run.
Alright. And what's that? That's number 17. Alright, Brian, you mark the halfway point. This is the pack number 18.
What pack number are you?
I don't 30 know.
30 something, right?
Well, the one I'm going to open is 30 something.
31 is his pack. Yeah. So you got to stay till the end to see the opening.
All right.
Roll that die. Let's see who's next. Oh, this is your two packs down here.
Okay.
20, number 19 and 20 are yours, Joe. Four.
Bond.
Battle Bond. Sweet.
What's his name?
Let's see what we get.
Who are the...
Rowan and...
Yeah.
Will and Will and Rowan? Kenrith? Yeah.
What is in Battle Bond? Like, I've never actually really messed with
Doubling Season.
Yep.
Doubling Season's in there. There's a lot of good stuff. Archfiend of Depravity is like a $40 card. Doubling Season's probably the big hit. Land Tax.
Oh my god, this is... That's right, Land Tax is in there.
Battle Bond's insane. It's such a good set. There's so much value in that set. And it was, I think it was one of the last, like, special summer drops that were, you know, normal price, like, $80, maybe 100 or something like that.
Hold on a minute. You know, like, common and common and stuff. So, is the rare, no, the rare is here. What is it?
Oh, it's Japanese, it's Peppers. It's a Japanese pack.
What's not Japanese, it's
English. Well, Japanese printed.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Swarm of Blood. Like a shock. Shock's always a good card. I've used this. I love that card, actually.
It's like a watered down freaking lightning bolt,
yeah,
dude.
It is.
As
it
a
is.
Lightning bolt fanatic, I have
I
to disagree.
I use so many lightning bolts.
Yeah.
Let's see what we got. Alright. Forest, guys. Super fun.
Whoa.
Alright, I don't know what that is.
Nyxothid. Womp womp.
It looks kind of cool. I mean, look at the dude like fighting
something.
It.
It
is
pretty,
like a
dude cool
fighting
art.
A huge sword.
Not a great Battle Bond pack. It could have been so much better.
But it was. Wah, wah.
Yeah, well, I wonder why it's doing that. It never does that. The little box thing. It's really annoying.
Oh, yeah.
You just put it on top.
Yep.
Yeah, it's like tracking.
Yeah, it's the autofocus thing, but it never does it. I don't know why it's doing it. That's really weird.
I pulled a Justin Herbert Black today. That was fun.
Is that
really? Out of which set?
Chronicles.
Yeah. Auto?
No, I wish it was an auto.
Oh.
Jesus.
Was it numbered?
No.
Oh.
It's still like about $100, $200 card, but it was like...
Oh, yeah, the black. I know which one you've done.
Yeah.
Prism.
Prism,
yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, okay, that's
yeah.
cool. And then just clicked now.
Exactly. Yeah, the Chronicle. Like, I went to the next, whatever it is, and bought all the packs, and I was like 20 of them, and I was just like, I'm going to open a few of these, and I was like, well, there's a Justin Herbert Black. That's probably the best card I could have pulled out of there.
Yeah. Where'd you get it at?
Next. Naval Exchange. I had a bunch of them sitting there. I was like, okay.
Which one? Omega?
The one at Oceana.
Really?
Yeah.
They actually had them in the store.
Yeah, there were literally just a bunch of them sitting there. I was like, okay, that's cool.
All
right. Next up is Matt Newcomb.
Matt Newcomb.
Matt's a veteran of our breaks.
Or Eldritch
Number 4.
Moon.
Eldritch Moon.
That's a good pack.
Yeah, it is. Matt's been in pretty much every break, I think.
This is love me so much. Rudy would just be like...
right? He's the fastest pack ripper I've ever seen.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
I've seen some people that are ridiculous. I'm trying to save the pack a little bit, though. That's the only reason why.
Yeah, so you at least put them back in.
Yeah, that's kind of why. I know it's not like an expensive pack or anything like that, but...
Eldritch Moon these days is probably like 8 to 10 bucks.
I was supposed to say 10 bucks.
Number 21.
That's a creepy looking dude. Like Dracula, but Gator.
Graph Rats. Oh, Hanwer Garrison.
That's kind of cool.
That's a good hit.
Is that the other side of it?
Yeah. And then, so you get that. That's your flip rare. And then you get a regular rare, too.
And this one?
It should be. Yep. Summary
Dismissal.
Hammer Garrison's a good $3, $4 hit. That's your hit in the pack. We've gotten so few bulk rares. Nyxothid, I think, was the only bulk rare, really. And there was a... trash Ixalan pack, too. But All right. Tony Hutz.
Tony Hutz.
Tony, also a veteran. When does Joe open? Soon, Matt, soon.
What? Yeah, soon. Theros.
Neil, what's up? Would love to link to the cardboard and plastic bag. Are they good for every booster? They are good for every booster. Sorry, Tim, I haven't been paying attention to the chat. Yes, every booster pack seems to be the same size no matter what, for the most part. So I'll post them in. I'll link you to my group, The Goods MTG, all one word with an A, not an E, on Facebook, and I'll post it in there so everyone can see it. Neil, what's up, dude? I'm a little sad you weren't the first person in here like you usually are. It hurts my heart a little bit, but I'll forgive you. We're opening pack number 31, and we're at pack number 21 right now. Where are we at? Oh, that's Tony's pack?
Yep.
Nice. Alright, Tony.
Alright, let's see what he gets.
Ooh, Purphoros. Got a mythic.
Mythic right now.
Pretty crappy mythic, but...
Yeah.
That Purphoros.
Yeah. The bad Purphoros. But, I mean, it's still a mythic hit.
Right? And a cool land.
And the cool broccoli land.
Yeah, see? Broccoli. Well, who doesn't love broccoli?
Kids don't love broccoli.
I don't know. My daughter is a freaking broccoli fiend.
Really?
Know. Yeah. Broccoli and peppers are her, like, jam. Mm.
Sounds like you raised her right.
Yeah, I guess.
How old is your daughter?
7.
Sounds like a fine age.
I go pick her up. Actually, tomorrow.
Nice.
Oh, you go get her for the summer?
Mm-hmm.
22, Tony. All right, next is James Curry. Roll it up for James. Oh, well, now we've got a hole in. Do you have any booster packs? Random booster packs? All right, yeah, let's do that.
Nay, I don't keep random.
Well, this one's going to have the, this one will have the invocation in it.
That's nice.
All right, let's do it. James, you're getting 2 packs to finish out row number 2.
I'm actually trying to find a box of this one. Like a sealed box.
I just saw that someone was selling a sealed case.
Sealed case?
For, I think it was $1,600?
That doesn't seem too bad case.
Not terrible. It may have been cheaper than that. Definitely was more than $200 a box.
Oh,
I made some money on Amaket. Almond cats? On the almond cats. Ooh, Hazoret's Monument. That's $1 uncommon.
Trial of Ambition. And your rare is...
Oh, Bantu the Glorified.
No, mythic.
Nice mythic. Nice mythic hit. Card
too.
Like that. Menace Indestructible.
Yeah, that's a good card.
Oh, this is cool.
Alright. It's number 23. Thanks.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
That's the last one? Nope, one more.
This is James's second pack. And finishing off the second row, we are officially 2/3 way through the box, guys. Matt's the trash demon.
Yeah.
Check the battery life real quick. Oh, it looks good. Totally fine. We got time.
Well, we're probably third way done too, so that works out.
All right. Next up, we have Mark Goldwell's 3rd pack. So we don't need to roll for him. We'll just pack it up. Thanks for taking that last spot, Mark. It's kind of funny. We're just going to have it, you know, sealed as like a thing like we did with the Tempest Break. And like 3 people asked about it after you grabbed it. I'm like, sorry, it's sold. If anyone wants to give up their pack or one of their packs, there are people probably in my group that might want one. So
for what, the Tempest?
No, for this. Because after it was filled, like, we got a bunch more inquiries about it.
Oh,
like,
really?
Guys, it was up for, like, 2 weeks. I mean...
Yeah, it was up for a while.
You know, there's time. There was plenty of time. Like, we were worried it wasn't going to fill.
I gave one of my packs away. Like, I bought another pack, and then, like, everybody started buying them all, like, almost immediately.
Yeah, something weird happened. I don't know.
I was like, what is going on?
All right, Mark, that was your third pack. Timothy Galpin. Why is it doing that? This is your pack. There you go. Our friend in France.
Number three.
War of the Spark. Come on, let's get... what's the good hit in War? Lily? Nicobolas?
Nicobolas, definitely.
Lily's a good hit. I think she's still like 15, 20 bucks.
Oh, like it'll be,
Which Lily, though?
It's the Dreadhorde one.
Yeah, Dreadhorde General.
Yeah, you know, she's comes in... Liliana's on about, what, 10 cards?
Yeah, well, this set, Lily. Come on.
Yeah.
You're not open Lily of the Veil in War of the Spark, man.
Yeah, that's true. I do have a Lily of the Veil.
She just, like, spiked up to about 100 bucks now that Modern is a thing again.
I have a foil one.
Oh, yeah, that's, like, probably 100, or probably a couple hundred.
I don't know. My daughter's name is Lily, so I keep all of the Lily.
Did you name her after Liliana?
No, I didn't, actually.
Don't lie.
Surprisingly. But
don't you lie.
All right, let's see what we got going on here. Bold Bend. Okay, was that two or three? Okay, so we're going to get a rare one.
Oh, Domri Anarchibolas. That's a terrible planeswalker. But it is what it is. So if you get a rare planeswalker, you don't get a planeswalker and then a rare? I thought you got a planeswalker and then a rare. No, like, you get a double rare if you were getting a rare.
You get a planeswalker in every pack. So either you're going to get a rare planeswalker, or you're going to get...
That was the whole deal with...
Yeah.
But I was thinking, I was under the impression, like, with Eldritch Moon, if you get a flip rare, you get a flip in every pack, but if your flip is a rare, you also get a pack rare. So you have a possibility of... For some reason, I was thinking War of the Spark, but it's the same way.
No. You just get... It's like either you get an uncommon one or a rare mythic.
Yep. All right, Pierluigi is next. Pierre already got a roll.
Oh, he did? Okay.
Yeah, this is his third pack. No soup for you, Pierre. And then Eric Obayashi will be next with one pack. Which we will thank Pierre for giving up his fourth pack for Mr. Obayashi. What number is that? 26? This is 27.
Good number.
Wow. All right. Now you can roll.
All right, for
so I should pack a Joe open log, but I'll check out the bid. Oh, jeez. Good night, Timothy. I'll have your pack shipped out tomorrow. Hopefully it gets to you before 2022.
Another War of the Spark.
Another War of the Sparky for Mr. Obayashi. All
right, pack. This thing's just terrible. Whatever.
And Timothy, I'll add you to the group, bud, so you can see all the happenings that are going on. Welcome to the family.
How is he not in the group already? That's like
he's brand new.
That's the best group ever.
We just found him.
Oh,
he just found us.
And you said he sold it a lot at the Visions box?
The Visions box got sold.
Yeah.
To the same guy who bought the revised starter deck box.
Oh, really?
He bought Visions, Mirage, and the Revised Starter Deck.
How much did you do the Revised Starter Deck box for?
It was a total for all three. It was 24.
I thought you said it was about 15 or 14.
14 for the Revised Starter Deck box. He got a steal on it, in my eyes. I think it was worth 16.
See, and there's the uncommon one, so you don't get it.
Arlen. Oh, Vivian's Arcbow. That's a good playable.
And a devil.
Yeah, he did do pretty good on that.
Oh, he did great on it. And we did fine on it, you know? The Visions and Mirage were on consignment from a friend.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, we were just trying to get him his money back plus a couple bucks. So
nice.
It worked out well for that. All right, what do we got next? Ken Oliveri. Mr. Ken. Let's see. Wait, before you roll, let's move that over.
Do we have enough, you said? Do we have enough?
Yeah, we should have enough. Right. Yeah.
Three. Oh,
three.
I guess that's right.
There you go.
I guess
Ken's getting two packs.
294.
Oh, yeah. Not anymore.
Right? Amazing what some of these packs have skyrocketed up to.
I think they're like $5 a piece.
That's average, I guess. Not too bad.
Whatever I charged you, minus 10%. So I gave you a 10% increase in price for all the packs.
Increase? Yeah. Okay, cool. Sure.
I don't actually remember any of that, so.
What's the big hit here? Vanquisher's Banner would be good? Oh, Growing Rights of Iklamok.
Okay.
That would be the hit.
Alright, let's see what we got.
Champion. Oh, Deep Root Champion? That's not bad.
Yeah, it's a good card.
Yeah. It's a $2-$3 hit. Not bad. I dig. As long as we're not opening bulk rares, that is like my number one pet peeve, opening a pack and being like,
oh, that's good cards.
Yeah, there's been really good packs so far. Nothing insane though. I want to see something crazy happen. I want to see an invocation open.
Yeah.
Or
I haven't seen one I'm open.
I've never seen one open.
I've only opened
one. You've opened one?
I've opened one invocation.
Oh, let's see.
Or the other inventions and two inventions.
You opened two inventions?
Mm-hmm.
There we go. Which ones are inventions?
Kaladesh.
Oh, okay.
Which ones did you open?
Sort of.
Feast and Famine?
Yes, sort of Feast and Famine.
It's a good
$300
Alright, Joe. Now we're going to open a pack of revised, guys.
That was mine?
Yep, number 31.
Oh,
do the honors, dude.
Shit.
Do right. The freaking honors. All right.
What we got going?
Don't spill your bourbon on it.
Well, I'm out. Fortunately.
Right. Ooh. Let's see. 1994 open, guys. You ready for this?
Y'all ready for this?
Where's the red in this one?
Oh, God. I think it's second to last.
I've never opened revised.
I don't know if I'm opening or watching.
Yeah, it's probably second to last, would be my guess.
Second to last.
Alright, so we got a brain mass.
A brain mass? You mean a brass man?
Oh, yeah, brain mass. Brass man.
Right, hold on, let me.
Brain mass.
Let me zoom in on this.
I definitely
perfect.
Misread that. Dyslexic of much. A gloom. So sad. Wall of ice.
So pretty.
They are so pretty. Pack fresh revised.
They're super clean, too.
Ooh, demonic hordes. That's your rare.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Look at that.
That's awesome. That's a good rare.
Unfortunately, the centering's off.
Yeah, it was 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah.
The rare.
I thought that might be the case.
Hey, look, a mountain.
Ooh, hitting the camera. Woolly Mammoth.
Death Ward.
Oh, the best card in Revised, Death Ward.
Regenerate target creature. Oh, an island. How many lands are in this?
Oh, Earthbind.
Yeah,
love it.
Yeah,
pack fresh Earthbind.
Yeah, everyone loves that one.
Get a lightning bolt. Come on, dude.
Lightning bolt. Oh, another plane.
Yeah, everybody loves that one because she's sexy.
Yeah.
Sexy elf
circle
chick.
Protection.
All tied down and stuff.
A swamp.
I love that swamp. I don't know why. It always gets me in the feelies.
That wasn't
a
bad pack.
That wasn't
like,
a bad
there's
pack.
There's a lot of crappy rares you could have got.
Yeah. Lifelace.
Yeah.
Farmstead.
To mention a few.
Yeah, Demonic Hordes. You hit reserve list, pack fresh. Playable black rare. I mean, it's probably 40, 50 bucks. Pack
destroy
fresh.
Destroy one land.
Nah, it's a little left or right.
Yeah,
centering.
It's a little left. The centering is unfortunately a little fucked. But
that's right. Pay $300 to send it off to Beckett to get created.
Why am I spending $300 anywhere? That's crazy.
Well, that's the only service you can get these days.
July, PSA opens back up.
Really?
Yeah, but they weren't sure if they were going to open up the cheapest service again, though, they said.
Oh. No economy.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I don't like waiting for them to open up because I have
nice.
Bunch
all right,
of
Joe. Here's your second pack.
Excellent.
We'll keep this one sealed for you.
Yes, please. I need that sealed.
Well, this one's got the Underground Sea in it. Actually, is Trout better than Underground Sea these days?
I don't think so.
Is Underground Sea still the top? Trop outpaced it for like a hot minute.
It was like, I didn't realize there was so many lands in these old packs.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. There was literally four. I'm probably going to end up getting that one graded for fun.
Do it. I don't know if they're actually. Yeah, I wouldn't grade this pack, dude.
No, you're right.
Yeah, it's just, they're just smush. Now, packs out of your box.
This one would probably have been better. It's okay.
Right. He's like, oh, the one I owe to.
Yeah.
All right, pack number 32. Oh, wait.
Pack 10.
Did I do... Oh, you're 32, not 31. Sorry.
This was 31, yeah.
Yep. Let's just change that on camera. There we go. So now we're on pack 33.
Excellent.
All right. Pack 33 is going to be Philippe Maher. This is his second break with us.
First pack?
Yep. First pack. Give it a roll.
Two.
Number two, Hour of Devastation. All right, Philippe, let's get a freaking invocation. Someone's got to open an invocation.
We'll see.
Anyone else want to open their revised pack? Barry, you here? Jake Lay? Brian, your last pack?
Like this year.
You want to open?
Two Burrow rookie auto patches.
Really?
Yeah, I pulled one number 25. Those all
out,
the
out of what?
Huh?
Out of what?
Number 25?
No, out of what?
Obsidian.
Oh, okay.
Really nice patch too. And I have another one. I still have another one that's 75. And then I have a, dude, those Chronicles are loaded with rookies, though.
Really?
I probably pulled, like, 10 Herberts and 10 Burrows, almost, and a bunch of Tuas. I was, like, very surprised at how much I pulled. Like, I think the only other blacks I got were a CC and some Bales.
All right, Michelle, I'll open yours.
What?
So go ahead and open mine.
And
she
got, what is that?
Is that Michelle?
Raminet Excavator.
Ooh, Raminet! Nice, that's a good hit. There was a better hit before they reprinted it 18 times, but still a good hit. Still a good hit! Alright. That is pack number 33. On to pack number 34!
I like this. It's pretty.
Who's 34? Barry. I'd get divorced if I opened mine, so maybe.
Wow. So maybe? Oh my god.
All right, you got to give me a definite answer before pack number 36 comes up, Brian.
Who's next?
You got to let me know. Next is Barry. Barry Nordendale Jr. with pack number 34.
All right.
What do we got? Five left? We can't do a... All right, well, four. There we go. We'll just... And if we get the empty slot, we'll just keep rolling. I do have a four-sided die for the next one.
Oh, nice. Perfect.
I always bring all the sided dies. Isn't that a weird one?
One, two, three. Which one's the number?
The one that's up.
They're all up.
No, I know, but like when it's
they're all
when
the
it
same
late.
On the, each side.
So oh, I know. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Let's see what we got. We got
35.
Excellent.
Hey guys, we're coming to a close here. Sorry we only opened one revised pack, but it's understandable. The pricier these packs get, the more people are like, nah, I'm good. Keep it sealed.
Yeah.
No, yeah. Like I said, I just opened a $500 pack and pulled $50 in.
So. Yeah, I mean, I opened two Legends packs on one of the breaks, and Matt thinks I'm crazy.
That one, those are way more than these ones.
Well, but
$900 at that time?
Yeah,
but I got them for like $350, and there's so many $300
so
hits in Legends.
Worth $10,000 a piece, and you got it for $1. Would you still done it?
Yeah. Hell yeah. Bullshit. Hell yeah. But there were so many $300 cards in there at that time.
And now
you, know
and
I mean?
You didn't pull any of them.
I pulled a Near Mint Caracas.
So many.
Well, Legends is also a huge set. I'm building a full set of Legends right now. There's like 360 cards or something in Legends. It's as big as Revised. Almost as big as Ice Age. What's this number? 34? Whoa. Oh, I see what you're doing.
What?
I was like, whoa. Hold on there.
Oh, I'm just putting it on the back.
He was trying to
lock
it a pack when you were
But no, I thought he was putting it in there. I was like, wait a second. Wait.
That's not right.
All right, 35 is Jake Lay. Roll it up. Jake, you're the last pack. No, Brian is the last one.
Roll a four.
No can do, man. I hear you. We're not going to open you up.
Oh.
A three. Eldritch Moon. All right, what's the big hit in Eldritch Moon? Oh, Emrakul. Yeah, we'll open up the last three packs just for shits and giggles, guys.
Super fun. He means the last three packs are revised, so I don't know.
Yep. One pack left. Come on, let's get an Emrakul. That would be so Emrakul. Oh, Sigarda's Aid. Nice hit.
And what is this? Oh.
Oh, that's the flip. Oh, and a Bruna Fading Light. Nice.
I was about to say,
that's
yeah,
your
I mean,
flip rare. That's awesome. That's a great hit. Nope. That's not. That's an awesome hit, dude. Congrats.
Is there any value to the back of that card like that?
What do you mean?
In other words, the big card itself, which is made up of two cards.
Yeah.
Is there any value to them being as one? More than the separate individual just adding it together?
Probably not.
Yeah. I wouldn't think there is.
All right, Brian, this is the last one.
All right, Brian, you're the last pack. That concludes our $18,000 box break.
I know, right?
That's stupid. That's stupid,
so
yeah.
Insane.
Thanks, everyone, for participating and making this happen. We're super excited just to freaking break this thing open. For anyone who doesn't know the story, this came out of the beta starter deck that we had purchased. And then we sold that, and part of the sale was for this revised box. So, Brian, you're going to get the box, too. It's in pretty good condition. We got a little tear here on the side, but it's in pretty good shape otherwise. And I'll fold it down and make it all nicey to ship. All right. Let's open the last of these. You want to do the honors, Joe? Since you're the pack master, I'm going to sit here and drink whiskey and
see what we got.
Relax. Thanks, everyone, for coming out, making another successful break. Sorry about the autofocus thing the whole time. I don't know why. I really don't know why this happened. Oh, the Cylindvite Temple. Cylindvite.
Some Italian dude.
I've never seen that car. Oh, it's the Acacian Lieutenant.
Acacian Lieutenant.
Order of the Ebon Hand. Nice. Him to Turok. Ooh, this is a good pack. Order of the Ebon Hand and Him to Turok.
Yeah, the Order of which was also remade a billion times.
Yeah. All right. I want to open one.
Yeah, you want
an
Empire.
That was an Empire's pack, for sure.
That was definitely all right, Rainbow Veil's in this pack. We open Fallen Empires in every break.
Rainbow Veil.
Because we have so many. We have like 100 packs of Fallen Empires. All right, I'm just going to zoom in a little bit. We got Turok's Chant, Hollow Trees, the Thalid. That's my favorite art for Thalid. Look at that weird little dude. Come on, give me a focus. Look at that weird guy. Alright. Clearly we're not going to focus here. We got a Feral Thalid. Come on. Acacian Money Changer. Night Soil. Oh god, that is such a bad... That is a bad Fallen Empires pack.
Let most of them have
it. Yeah. Alright. You want to open that last one? Let's get an invocation. If we pull an invocation in this pack, we'll randomize the list, and whoever's at the top will get the invocation.
Nobody cares about any of this stuff. So.
Nope, nobody cares about commons. Although if there's a Bantu's Monument in the uncommon slot, that's a good card. It's a good pull.
Nope. Cast out. Let's see what we got.
Vizier of Many Faces, $1 rare. Ooh, and a foil cancel.
Yeah.
Ooh.
No.
No invocations, guys.
No invocations.
Later, Mark. Thanks, dude. Guys, everything will be shipped out tomorrow if I don't crash on the way home. That would be terrible. But yeah, everything will be shipped out tomorrow by post office close. Thanks for hanging with us. Wait, we gotta swap the camera, and everyone's gotta get in so you can see. Everyone can see the fam. There's Joe.
Oh, proper here.
There's Matt. Yeah. There's the crew tonight.
Hell yeah.
All right, guys.